Students, now move on to the question number 7. The question is, chalk contains calcium carbonate and oxygen in the ratio 10:3:12. Find the percentage of carbon in chalk. This is your first part of the question. Second part, if in a stick of chalk carbon is 3 gram, what is the weight of the chalk stick? This is the second part of your question. So first, what you will find, whatever ratios are given to you, from that you will find the percentage of carbon in chalk. So let's see.
So what is given? Calcium is to carbon is to oxygen. This ratio is given, which is equal to 10:3:12.
So we have to first find the total of these parts,
which is equal to 10 + 3 + 12, which gives you 25.
So total is your 25.
Now the first part, percentage of carbon in chalk, that we want to find. So the ratio is what? 3 out of 25. This is the fraction, or this is the ratio for the carbon that is present in the chalk sticks. So 3 divided by 25 is the fraction. Now we have to convert that into percentage. So multiply by 100%. When you solve this, 3 into 100 divided by 25. 25 fours are 100 and 3 fours are 12. So what is the answer? 12%. 12% is the carbon that is present in the chalk stick. Now the second part, you have to find the total weight of the chalk sticks. Now we know the part is part 12%. We know that 12% of the total is 3 gram. That is we know, because it is already given in your question. So let the weight of the stick is equal to x. Total we don't know, but part we know. 12% of total is equal to 3 gram, that we know, because the weight of the carbon in the chalk stick is already given, that is 3 gram. So part is given and total we want to find. So 12% of x is equal to 3 gram. So solve this. So 12 divided by 100 multiplied by x. Whenever you remove the percentage sign, you have to divide the term by 100. 12 divided by 100 multiplied by x is equal to 3. So x is equal to what? 3. This 100 is in division, that we go over here as a multiplication. This is in multiplication, we go here as a division. So 3 multiplied by 100 divided by 12. 3 4s are 12. 4 25s are 100. So what is the answer? X is equal to 25 grams. So we can say that weight of chopsticks is equal to 25 grams. So this way we can solve question number 7. Move on to the next question, question number 8. Student, question number 8, try to do by yourself. Here, what is given? You are given the cost price, loss percent, and you have to find the selling price. You can use the formula, selling price is equal to 100 minus loss percent divided by 100 multiplied by cost price. So with the help of that formula, you can solve question number 8 by yourself. Now move on to the next question. Question number 9. What is the question? Find the amount to be paid at the end of 3 years in each case. So what is given? Principal is equal to rupees 1200. Rate of interest is equal to 12% and time duration is given, that is 3 years. So here we want to find the amount. Before we find the amount, we have to find the simple interest. So simple interest is equal to PRT upon 100. P is your principal, R is rate of interest and T is time. So P is 1200. Rate is 12%, time is 3 divided by 100. This 2 0 will get cancelled. But 12 into 12 is 144. 144 multiplied by 3. 4 is 12. 4 is 12 + 1 = 14. 3 + 3 + 1 = 4. So what is the answer? Rupees 432. This is your simple interest. Now we want to find the amount. So amount is equal to what? Principal plus selling simple interest. So this is equal to 1200 + 430. So what is the answer? 1632. So this is the amount. When you find the simple interest, that simple interest you have to add into the principal so that you are getting the amount. Okay, again I am explaining what is given. Principal is given, rate of interest is given, and time period is given. We know the formula to find simple interest, that is equal to PRE upon 100. P is your principal, R is rate of interest, and T is your time. Substitute the value of 1200 into 12 into 3 divided by 100. 20 will get cancelled. 12 into 12 is 144. That you have to multiply with 3. Your answer is rupees 432. This rupees 432 is what your simple interest. Now amount is equal to what? Whatever principal plus simple interest will give you amount. After doing addition, you are getting 1632. So this way we can find the amount when the principal rate of interest is given to you. Next part, that is B, that you will do by yourself. Same formula you have to apply. Move on to the next question, that is question number 10. See the next question, that is question number 10. The question is, what rate gives rupees 280 as interest on a sum of rupees 56,000 in 2 years? So here what is given? Principal is given, simple interest is given, time is given. What you want to find? What rate, means rate of interest we have to find. You have listed out all the datas. Principal given, time is given, simple interest is given. What is not given? Rates, that we have to find out. So we know the formula that simple interest is equal to PRE upon 100. So here what we want to find? R. So we can make R as formula. So R is equal to what? Simple interest multiplied by 100 divided by P into T. Now substitute the value. Your simple interest is 56,000 multiplied by 100 divided by what is your simple interest is 280. Divided by principal 56,000 multiplied by time is 2. When you do the calculation, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 3 0 will get cancelled. Okay. 2, 14 the 18 and 14, 4 the 56. So what is the answer? 1 divided by 4%. Now 1 divided by 4 means 0.25%. So rate of interest is what? 0.25%. Again I am repeating. First of all, list out all the data. Principal is given, time is given, simple interest is given. What is not given? Rate. That we have to find. We know the formula to find simple interest. So simple interest is equal to PRT upon 100. We make R as a formula. So R is equal to what? Simple interest multiplied by 100. Whatever here in multiplication, that will go here as a division. Substitute the value, do the cancellation, you will get the answer 1 by 4, that is 0.25%. Next, move on to the question number 11. See question number 11. The question is, if Veena gives an interest of rupees 45 for 1 year at 9% rate per annum, what is the sum of, what is the sum she has borrowed? So here what is given? Interest is given, simple interest is rupees 45, time is given, that is 1 year, rate of interest is given 9%. So what we want to find? Principal, that is not given. So simple interest is equal to PRE upon 100. So what is principal? So P is equal to simple interest multiplied by 100 divided by R into T. Substitute the value. 45 multiplied by 100 divided by 9 into 1. We know that 9 5 is 45 and 5 into 100 will give you rupees 500. So what is the principal? So therefore, principal is equal to rupees 500. So this is our answer. So this way we can solve question.
question number 11. So here your exercise 8.3 is completed, as well as our chapter comparing quantities also completed. Meanwhile, if you have any question and query, you can ask me during the attendance time period, that is 1:30 to 2:30. No personal message for any queries. Again, I am repeating, any query if you have, put a message in WhatsApp group only. No personal message for that, neither personal call. Okay, so any doubts I will solve you. So just go through all the videos of this chapter. Try to complete exercise 8.1.